Hi friends, in this video I want to show you how to stop the stop message of computer in a blue screen, okay, and why this has occurred. Okay friends, okay, this problem will occur in three ways. The one way is if you remove the CMOS battery, means this one is the CMOS battery, the small battery in the motherboard which makes the data and time to run. And the second option is if the RAM is failure or the CPU fan is not running, okay. And the third option is the hard disk. If hard disk fails, this happens. And the solution is if you remove the CMOS battery and switch on the computer, that means the BIOS settings have been erased, and you have to do the same settings which is there in the first time, which make the computer to run, okay, to run and install your OS. That means now, because of you removed the CMOS battery, the system erased all the BIOS settings in it. The another problem is that the RAM, if the RAM does not work or it works just for a while and again stops working, it may did not start the PC. That means borrow a RAM which is compatible with your motherboard, like DDR1, DDR2 or DDR3, which is compatible. You can select that or borrow from your someone who you know and replace and take your with and replace that with this one and just start the computer. If all things work fine, then you need to replace your RAM, okay. And if even though after installing the RAM it does not work, then you should check with the hard disk. The hard disk may be the problem. Take your hard disk, the friends, and perform chkdsk operation. If that fails, you should replace your hard disk. Or the another problem is that if your motherboard is dusty, it may happen some times. Then you have to clean your motherboard well and make sure that you should not use cloth. You should use the air blower which removes the dust by blowing air high speedly, or if you do not have the air blower, you can select the alternate option, but don't use the wet cloths, etc. After that, write picture as the, that means you should note the wires and the devices which are there in the motherboard in a paper. That means you do not do any wrong while connecting the wires and it may be harmful to your computer. So first write in a paper where the wire should be kept, and then you should remove then you can remove and clean the dust, and after that, according to that paper, you can attach the wires accordingly. And this may be the problem. If these four ways does not work, then the last one is your motherboard, and you should check with the technician that your motherboard is failed, or you can update your BIOS if the motherboard is correct, okay. Okay friends, if the problem is arisen due to the removal or change of CMOS battery, let's see what to do and how to install the OS. Now switch on the computer, and after switch on the CPU. Okay, now for entering into the BIOS, press F2 or delete button in your computer. The key depends on your motherboard, okay, motherboard type or company. Okay, keep on press the delete key and the BIOS settings will open. And in these settings, make sure that these settings should be in your computer. And in the standard OMS or general, see that the date and time should be correct, and this is the hard disk and not this. In this 4, anyone will be the hard disk version, and again is the CD-ROM. Okay, and see that there is a halt on button. If your computer has this option, select no errors, select enter. After entering, there are many options, select no errors. Okay, and after that press escape, or if your motherboard BIOS is different, press tab. Okay, after go to the advanced BIOS features or advanced boot options or advanced settings in your BIOS if this type of BIOS is different to your computer. And in the first boot device, select CD-ROM, and the second has the hard disk or something. If you want to boot your computer from CD-ROM, then select the first boot device as CD-ROM, and if you want to boot from USB, then you should select the first boot device as USB. Okay, make sure that the HDD smart capability is enabled and do not change anything in this, and this may lead to malfunction of your system. Okay, now go to integrated peripherals and make sure that USB control is enabled and USB support, and this one is also enabled. If you are using USB keyboard, then this should also be enabled, and these are all the same, leave it like that. And now PC health status, this should be the CPU warning, temperature is disabled, CPU fail warning, system fail warning. CPU smart fan control, this one you select according to your computer. Okay, and reset to case open status, this one you keep enabled. Okay, that means if you open the BIOS, it will not show you as you have opened the, or if you select the disabled option, it will show you have opened the case. Things have been done. Press the F10 button. In any BIOS system, F10 is the key to save, and after enter Y and enter, press enter. After that, now I am selecting the boot device as CD-ROM. Make sure that the CD-ROM is already installed in your computer and the disk contains the boot CD, Win7 or WinXP, whatever you want. Now see, after press any key to boot from CD or DVD. Now Windows setup, as if you are is already installed in your computer the version which you are installing, then you can also try with recovery mode, or you can do the setup. Nothing will be done if you select the setup. Now the Windows files are loading, please wait until it loads. Till the Windows loads the files, and if you do not have the boot CD or DVD or booting USB, please be connected to my channel. I will show you then how to create a boot CD or boot DVD or boot USB with downloading from the internet. Okay, in the next video. And now I am showing for those who have boot CD or DVD or USB, or the CD which is given to you when you purchase US. Okay. 3 to 4 minutes till this screen appears. Okay, now select the English language or the language which you are compatible, and the keyboard or input method is also US language, that means English. And now select the next. The mouse should be required for this, and after that press install now. Okay, now the setup process is starting. That means you are installing Windows in your hard disk. Okay, Windows 7. The XP is also same procedure. You can try if your motherboard does not support Win7. Friends, wait till the 3 to 4 minutes again, and this is the CD which have all the Windows 7 options, like Windows 7 Starter, Windows 7 Ultimate, Windows 7 Professional, all package. If you have only one package, then you have to do continue next. And if you have the list of packages which you want to install, then you have to select one from those. The best is the Windows 7 Ultimate SP1 Retail. Into 86 is the 32-bit, and into 56 or 54 or something is the 64-bit. So if your motherboard is compatible with 32-bit, then install 32, or if else if 64, then install the into 56. I am installing the 32-bit, which is Windows 7 Ultimate SP1 Retail into 86. Okay, that means you are choosing the 32-bit. Okay, now accept the license terms. Okay, then click next. Okay, do not, if you see that your computer is in problem and it's not starting, then select the custom and see the disk partitions in your disk. Okay, and you select all, you delete all the disks. Please wait, friends, it is taking time. Okay, now select driver advanced options. Now format fully. If you have the important data, you can format only the C drive which contains the OS, or else if you don't want any data, or if you have the backup, then you may delete all the you may format all the disk partitions. Okay, I am formatting the C drive, D drive, and I am formatting just the C drive because I have the data. That's why I am formatting only one. After selecting the disk partition, wait for 40 to 50 minutes and the Windows will install all the required files, etc. And then it will restart your computer, and again you have to wait for 10 minutes. It will prepare a icon or user access icon, and it will ask for you the name. Enter the name, and after all the process, your computer again restarts and it will prepare a desktop for you, and you can use the computer. Okay friends, thank you for watching this video, and it takes time for preparing my desktop, nearly 10 minutes. Okay, thank you, and please subscribe to my channel for more and more updates.